As usual, CES brought more questions around TVs than it answered. Yes, we have a feel for what we're gonna see this year, but what's marketing hype and what is actual technology? What is QNED, OD0, and where do QDEL and QD-OLED fit in the mix? Let's talk about that. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison, and today I want to explore where we are currently at with TV technology, what it means, and where we are going in the future. It involves a lot of acronyms, which, even if you are vaguely familiar with them, they're hard to keep track of and understand. I'm going to spell it all out as clearly as I can so that by the end of this video, you will be the most TV tech savvy person on your block, maybe even in your neighborhood. Let's get to it. Real quick though, do you think all these acronyms for TV tech are getting out of control? And why is your answer not yes? Leave me a comment down below, and while you're at it, I would appreciate you smacking that like button and hitting subscribe because it really helps us make the best videos we can for you. Once again, I thank you. Okay, let's go. I'm betting that many of you are already familiar with mini LED and micro LED and how they are different. But just in case, here's a quick refresher. Mini LED is a newish backlighting technology. In many ways, it is similar to the LED backlighting we've had for years in that it provides all the light for an LCD panel to work with. Mini LED works with much smaller LED lights and lots more of them, allowing for more precise control to minimize halo around bright objects on dark backgrounds and provide better shadow detail and peak brightness. Micro LED is different in that it involves no LCD panel or backlights at all. In some ways, it's similar to OLED in that tiny LEDs provide emissive red, green, and blue pixels. Like OLED, micro LED displays can provide perfect black levels and zero halo, but unlike OLED, they are not susceptible to burn-in, and they can get extremely bright. Micro LED is also outrageously expensive, and currently Samsung is the only player trying to put micro LED in people's homes. Now, Sony is bringing its crystal LED display tech to the US, but that appears to be a commercial play. Right now, Samsung is the only one targeting consumers. Speaking of Samsung, let's talk about Neo QLED. QLED, as you know, is a conventional LED backlighting technology that uses quantum dots to expand color and brightness. So what's the Neo part? Well, it's essentially Samsung branding of mini LED backlight tech that we just talked about. Samsung probably has some other proprietary tricks going into these TVs, but when you think Neo QLED, think next-gen mini LED tech. Now, we're seeing a similar move from LG this year. You may have heard that LG's latest for LCD-based televisions is QNED Mini LED. Unlike Samsung, LG's being pretty clear that its use of QNED is actually mini LED display technology. That part is pretty straightforward. But what gets confusing is that QNED is an established acronym for an entirely different kind of display tech that has nothing to do with mini LED backlights. So what is QNED supposed to be? I'm gonna explain exactly that in just a moment. But first, there's one more mini LED technology coming this year, and that's TCL's OD0. OD0 is what TCL is calling its next generation of mini LED backlight technology, which reduces the number of layers involved in the panel to offer an extremely thin profile. Now, it appears that at least Samsung has something similar going on in at least some of its Neo QLED TVs, but TCL, given it has been churning out mini LED TVs for a couple of years ahead of its competition, probably has something special up its sleeve. So while we don't know which TCL models will get OD0, we do know that TCL will be making some of its TVs look very special indeed. Okay, back to QNED. QNED, according to what was established before LG started using QNED as a marketing badge, probably intended as quantum nano cell emitting diode, has historically stood for quantum nano emitting diode, no nano cell involved. And the technology involves something called nanorod LEDs. To understand how this works, it helps to understand why OLED TVs, despite offering beautiful picture quality, are not especially efficient and fall far from being perfect. OLED TVs use a blue OLED material, which is then swung to white using a yellow OLED material. That white light can then be converted to red, green, and blue using a color filter. QNED would use nanorod LEDs, a slick and tiny cylindrical housing for little LEDs to produce that blue light at a subpixel level, with quantum dots using that blue light to make red and green pixels. This would mean OLED quality black levels and color accuracy, but with much higher brightness and no burn-in potential because no organic compounds are used. It's kind of a best of both worlds version of OLED and QLED with none of the drawbacks either. There is, however, a competing TV technology in development that keeps OLED around and would likely come before true QNED. And that brings us to the next TV tech acronym on the list, QD-OLED. As the name suggests, there is sort of a blend here between quantum dots and OLED. Here's how it works. Remember what I just said about how OLED TVs work? They start with a blue OLED light source, convert that to white using yellow OLED material, and then use a color filter to get red, green, and blue out of that white light. This is the white subpixel strategy upon which LG Display's OLEDs have worked, and it's part of the reason burn-in can be a problem and why brightness has been limited for HDR. QD OLED still uses a blue OLED light source, but it kicks the yellow OLED and color filter to the curb. Instead, it uses quantum dots to convert the blue light into red and green, so you have red, green, and blue pixels, a true RGB OLED. Now, since there's no color filter involved, up to 70% of the light that is usually lost to that color filter is reclaimed, meaning you keep the perfect blacks of OLED, but now this OLED-based display gets way brighter and increases color volume. It might, and I say might very intentionally here, also eliminate burn-in. Now, we don't have a QD OLED display to show you because there isn't one we've been shown yet, but it is possible this tech could be shown off in 2022, and that's very exciting. It could be the stepping stone we need to get a true QNED TV, which right now sounds like the most viable alternative to micro LED that we talked about at the beginning of this video, bringing us full circle on where TV tech is today and where it may be in the future. Nope, you know what? Hold on a second. There is one more, and that would be QDEL. That's quantum dot electroluminescence. And that would be if we used quantum dots with electricity to make their own light. There would be no backlight, there would be no OLED, there would be no nanorods. It would just be quantum dots lighting up the scene, and that would be truly amazing. Unfortunately, that tech has a ways to go. Right now, the red and green nanoparticles are suitable for this kind of application, but the blue is lagging behind. So it looks like it'll be a few more years before we might see any kind of prototype QDEL display. Will there be more acronyms to digest in the future? Almost certainly. But for now, you know more about TV tech than most of the folks you know. So go ahead, tell your friends, and let's all be excited for what the future holds. Thanks, as always, for watching, everyone. Please, did you find this video helpful? Did it clear up any confusion for you? Please let me know in the comments. And if it did, slap that like button and hit subscribe so we can continue to bring explainers like this to you in the future. And since you're here, there's two other videos I think you'll like.